hosting University of Kisubi, where the Electoral Commission vetted 5 candidates to run for the Guild presidency. And at this particular moment, I want to give the live audience an opportunity in case they have questions they would like to ask or pose to any of the candidates we have in the house tonight. And I'm passing on to my colleague, Joanne. How are you doing once again? Are the people enjoying the debate?
I'm doing well, and thanks for the opportunity. Dear viewers, thank you for joining us on Urban TV. And tonight we have the people from the campus of Kisubi. And right before me is the audience, the supporters for the main 5 candidates in Studio A. And allow me check their energy. Kisubi University, oye! Kisubi University, oye! Back to you, Kasmil.
We have some people with questions in the audience that they would like to pose to any of the candidates we have.
Yes, we do.
All right. Let me listen to them.
Thank you very much. I'm Wesley Octavius, and my question goes to Mr. Simon. Mr. Simon, we have been having our good presidents, the former good presidents, and they have been trying to make sure our university reduces tuition, because our university is very expensive, and more so to, more especially to private students. If you're elected as a good president, what are you going to do to make sure that they reduce tuition for private students? Because we know that you don't have shares in the University of Kisubi. Please, can you tell us what you will do to make sure you convince them and they reduce tuition to us private students? Thank you very much.
Yeah, this is Mwangs Paul. This question specifically goes to Honorable Komukesh Francis. Now, there is a very big difference between a weekend student and a full-time student. Now, I'm here just to ask you some questions. Rather, I can call it a question. Which strategies are you going to apply, rather than are you going to put in the practice in order to make sure that you bridge that distance that has been between the weekend students and the full-time students? Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. I'm Francis Mwangusha, and my question goes to Simon Peter. Simon, articulate to the audience the achievements you've had in your life so far that gives you the confidence to be the guild president of such a giant university, which is unique. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm Kasita Alex Sam. My question goes to Mr. Simon and Madam Daisy. Students for weekend, they have a challenge of having lectures in weekly days. Which strategy have you laid to help them to get their lectures as they applied in the university? Thank you.
Yes, and my name is Ofoke Leonard, the Excellentia, the Genius. My question goes to Mr. Simon. When we consider the University of Kisubi as a giant university, we just spoil the previous government. So my question to you now is, how are you going to lead University of Kisubi, since you said in your manifesto that you are the voice of the student, and students has been having so many struggles, nobody has heard their voice? How are you going to do that?
Thank you, Kasmil. Let's get back to you.
Candidate Rukundo Vincent. Anyone who wants to pose a question to Mr. Vincent? Okay. I think they can't get me very well. All right, let's get back to you, my candidates in the house. A couple of questions have been raised, and I think, Simon Peter, you have a couple of questions that have been raised. But before even we go there, let's listen to Mr. Vincent. We would like to know, what's your long-term plan? Question that was raised to all of you.
Okay, thank you very much. My long-term plan is to make sure that we have a university which is collaborating with other institutions. And when you check the University of Kisubi, that the guild council is not enough to facilitate itself. So I'm aiming at least having a project that will be helping the Guild Council so that it can facilitate itself in case of any need.
What kind of strategy? Can you just give us a few hints about that strategy, even if you don't explain it much? Yeah, because we don't want to, you know, we want to go into details a little bit. People would like to know those solutions you have.
When you check the location of our university, it is being surrounded by a lot of gardens. For example, the Brothers Gardens, and those people who have the gardens, they don't have the gadgets to use in, for example, the music system. And I feel like if we have this music system, it can help the Guild Council to earn for them almost every weekend, where we usually have functions almost every weekend. And this can be achieved by collaborating with the university administration, students, also even the alumni and other companies outside. Thank you very much.
All right, pass the microphone to the candidate next to me. How unique is your long-term plan? I want you to convince people, because you know this is a platform where you're going to speak to millions of people.
Well, thank you so much, Mr. Moderator. In my previous leadership, I held so many responsibilities, like the guild, like the social work president for all students in Uganda, and then the social work president at University of Kisubi, the regional spokesperson for UNSA. So I have been a person who is so much exposed and got a lot of experience in my due course of leadership. Just within 1 year in my university, I held two big events that mobilized around 500 university students in this country, and that was the launch of social work in 2016, and that was held at the university. That was already
now, you
a strategy.
Are the person who was already into the politics of this university. You have tested the waters before. You know exactly what's going on. There's an issue of sports. There is no gender balance when it comes to sports. The main relevancy when it comes to sports is only football for the males. What are you going to do about that to make sure that we have gender balance in these co-curricular activities?
Well, that's a very good question, and that deserves an answer by me. Well, the issue of gender balance at the University of Kisubi is very simple. We need to empower these individuals to mobilize themselves. And how are we going to do it? We need Minister of Sport who can socialize freely with the people, encourage them, and also as a government, we need to motivate these sportsmen and women so that they get to mobilize other people and feel it at home to see that University of Kisubi is exposed to other areas of sports and even introducing other sports for those who have less energy, like tennis, where everybody can get involved. That is my vision, and that's what I intend to do as soon as I become
now,
the president.
Now, talking about the questions that were raised by the audience, which is made up of your voters, all of you, the five candidates. A question was raised by Mr. Paul saying there is a very big boundary between the weekend students and the full-time students. What are you going to do? What's your strategy in uniting these two?
Thank you so much, Mr. Moderator. To tell you the fact, even I am a weekend student, and that's why I came in, because I know the experience we go through. But how do we make it? My platform is very clear. I am going to introduce a free dialogue that we are supposed to have it. Even in our constitution, we are supposed to have a general assembly every semester. That is the background we are going to use to sit together and negotiate and see how best we can bring all these two bodies on board. Because naturally, these people have been sidelined, even including the function, such function like today, they are not there. Yeah. We have been going through over the weekdays, and yet they are part of us that need to be included. So it is my responsibility as the Guild President to see that these two gaps are bridged. And in fact, in my manifesto, when you look at academics, it talks about giving weekend students priority to do exam on weekend days so that they don't have issues with their bosses at workplace. So that is my first agenda on the board. There was a question asked about a long-term plan. Well, advertising University of Kisubi is very simple. I'm a project writer, and right now I have a project proposal that I'm going to submit to take a regional balance in every district in this country so that the university get exposed, reach even the village, leave alone the Facebook, the media, and other things. We need people to be there in the village. We need to reach them where they are and encourage and bring people on board. Even looking at sponsors, because we have sponsorship at the University of Kisubi for teachers, we can as well lobby for other sponsorships so that more students come back on board. And that's my vision, that is my interest, and that's what I'm looking for, to see that the University of Kisubi grow bigger every single day.
Okay, thank you very much. Now pass the microphone to the candidate next to you. If I'm to go to Facebook, let me just read a few comments, like three. A lady called Moro Fabio DK says, yeah, I'm from Chambogo University. All the honorables are very convincing, but I'm only impressed by the only lady who came up. She's really tactical in her questions and answering. That goes to you, Daisy. That is a round of applause for you. Then we have a gentleman called Angel Israel, doing a PhD in IT and communication, watching in from Kenyatta University in Kenya. You say, what change the country is going to bring in? And I'm going to pose that to Mr. Vincent. What change, according to the situation you have seen, among others, if we're to live on sports and the long-term plan, what changes do you really want to bring the university? This is a question from somebody in Kenya.
Okay, thank you very much for that good question. There are a lot of changes we can have in the university that will help to empower the students and the university at large. For example, when you check the University of Kisubi, it has a lot of facilities, based on the science department, but the students we have not yet reached the level of making research projects, and this one can even help to earn the students. So if we can get a project whereby students can make their own research projects and they sell them out, it will be a better idea to motivate other students and also to empower students' skills. Thank you very much.
All right. And Simon Peter, I'm going to cross the microphone to you directly because you have a couple of questions. There is a question raised by Mwesije in the audience saying that the university is too expensive for them. If you are elected to be the next guild president, what exactly are you going to do to make sure we have a reduction on the tuition students pay at UNIC?
Thank you very much for that question. It's really true that the university charges a lot of tuition to the students, but that happens to every growing institution simply because they face a challenge of funds and they need funds to run the activities. The first thing that I'll work on in order to see that the tuition is reduced, putting projects in place. For example, the university has a lot of land whereby we can carry out agriculture, and also we have structures in place, conference rooms, we have fields. This can be rented out and we get money in order to subsidize the tuition that we pay. So in such a way, I think the best way to reduce this tuition, when you elect me as the guild president, I'll make sure that I'll bring these ideas in place and also emphasize it to the administrators, because the way to get numbers is through reducing the tuition, as the law of demand states that when the price is high, the demand is always low. Yes, thank you
very much. And of course, on Facebook, Tumosime Nelson says, Buyingana Simon Peter is our president. Pass the microphone to Daisy. Still on Facebook, Boniface Love, you said Daisy Komtima is our president. How different is your plan when it comes to tuition reduction in the university from what he has said?
Well, I believe in marketing more the university. It should be marketed. Its name should be branded more. Because when you market properly, eventually you attract more customers, and those are us, the students. Meaning, with increase in number of students, the tuition will eventually go down. And then also lobby for change with the administration. Talk to them and see the need for the reason why tuition should be reduced, because most of the students actually fail to sit for final exams, which is so bad.
Thank you very much. Pass the microphone to the next candidate. And of course, still checking out on Facebook, a gentleman called Owesi James said Rukundo is our president. Big up to Urban TV. Thank you very much, Mr. James. There is a problem of tuition. What can you do if you're elected the next guild president? What can you do that is really convincing to the audience watching in from that university?
Thank you so much for the question. I emphasize about the tuition, the increase of the tuition in my manifesto. And that is why I am coming to be the guild president of the university. I have my plan of sitting together with the administrators in collaboration with the guild representatives and the guild council to make sure that we discuss on what is affecting the student, especially when it comes to tuition, to know how best we can reduce it. Not only that, I have also a project in which we can get sources of income, like and getting music system, which we can also utilize our own DJ. We have a lot of DJ at the university. We have musicians who can also work with the music system, and we can rent it to other institutions and organizations and get fund as well to help and pay students tuition.
All right, let's listen to Mr. Rukundo. Tell us about your strategy when it comes to tuition.
Okay, thank you very much. When you check the tuition of the University of Kisubi, yes, it is indeed almost high, but the only solution, we can have what I can say scholarships. For example, can administration can bring a strategy or a policy and say, all the incoming students and the new entrants, we are going to give them maybe like half bursary of the scholarship. Let's say if someone is paying 1.5, then we have half bursary, he pays maybe like 750. Or we can also say we are reducing the tuition from where it is. We say, now the new entrants, we can either say the best performers or the ones who have talents, we are giving them a scholarship of maybe three-quarter system. So if someone is paying like three quarters of the tuition, that is the best way how we can reduce the tuition of the university. The second way is collaborating with outside organizations and say if there is any, like for example, MasterCard, which is at Makerere University, it can intervene in and also provide scholarships to some students.
Okay, thank you very much. Pass the microphone to Mr. Kumakesh. Do you agree, are you okay with the current tuition strategy we have, or would you think it needs change, it needs to be reduced?
Well, I'm one of those who have been frequently visiting the finance department of the University of Kisubi and asking why is it expensive. I realize that we should know that every intake has its own cost. But what I'm going to do as a guild president, we are going to sit down and I am going to advocate to these policymakers of the university to see that the certain things are scrubbed down so that it gives a platform where even a poor person can go through the university. But in fact, the current meetings which have been going on, and I believe with the next coming month or semester, you will find that there is a big change because I've been in touch and I know what is going on, and I believe that the University of Kisubi, they are so brilliant that they can listen to people's cry.
All right, let's take some calls. Anybody online? And hello, caller.
Hello.
Yes, what's the name and where are you calling from?
My name is Golet K. I'm from Unique.
Okay. Step away from your TV set, please. Step away from your TV set, please. Go on, you can ask your question.
Hello?
Yes, please.
Good evening.
Good evening. How are you doing?
I'm calling Master David.
Yes, Philip.
And I happen to be an alumni of that university, Kisubi.
Oh, wonderful. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Okono.
Yes, please. Any question or comment?
Sorry?
Question or comment?
Yes, my comment is about how those people are trying to convince the audience. And because during our time of administration,
go on, please.
Hello?
Oh, we lost
it. We had a weakness of the constitution. Which constitution had been adopted from Uganda Matters University in Kosi. Now I understand it is an independent university.
Yeah, please.
How are they going to shift that constitution of Uganda Matters University to be of University of Kisubi, because it is an independent university? That's one. Two.
Yeah.
Then two, it is about the tuition. As we try to advocate, about reduction of tuition at that institution, they had to remove. Because by the time I joined there, we had meals, I wanted and so forth. Everything was scrapped off and was privatized.
Okay.
And I understand the students are suffering a lot. Because currently, even my sister left the university because of the tuition, e-feeding, and what and so forth, which seems to be hectic and costly, whatever, to students. How is it going to be handled?
Okay. Thank you very much. Do we have any more callers online? Yes, caller, how are you? Oh, sorry, we lost that one. Any other call online?
Hello?
Yes, please. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
I'm Boniface.
Yes, Boniface.
Yeah, from Kisubi University.
Yes, please.
So, my question goes to Simon Peter.
Yes.
So it goes, if he comes to be, so he becomes the great president of University of Kisubi, and he finds there are some gaps in the good government that need to be rectified, how is he going to rectify them if he happens to become the president?
Thank you very much, Boniface. He will respond to that. Any other caller? Yes, caller.
Hey, how are you?
Fine, how are you doing? What's your name? Where are you calling from?
My name is Steven Chuanka from Mentere.
Yes, please.
I'm a student of Unique University.
Okay, go on.
And my question goes to both Simon and Kumake. All the previous guild presidents have been sort of puppets to the university administration, and it is hard to point out any achievement of the previous guild president. How do they, you know, convince us as voters that they are going to be quite independent and out of their way to achieve, you know, what the students want and not what the university administration wants?
Thank you so much. Let's have one more caller before we could listen to the candidates. Any other person online?
Hello.
Yes, please. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from University of Kisubi. This is Charles.
Sorry?
This is Charles. I'm calling from Mpala in Tebe.
Yes, yes. Mpala.
Yes. I would like to put the question to all the candidates. Hello?
Yes, I can hear. Go on.
Now, one of the things that they've talked about, some talk passionate about sports. Yes? But they're just talking about joking about it, the whole thing. But what I want, just a comment, all of them, is that you cannot improve sports in Unique, in Kisubi, unless you have a sports union. So whoever goes through, they should make sure Kisubi has a sports union, so that sports has a budget. Even if you have 500 students, and each one pays 10,000 per semester, post has a budget, they know they are spending how much on each team, SS soccer, rugby, and other sports that are around the institution. So they should make their plans for sports very clear to all of us, because I'm an alumni, and I'm the chairman of the rugby club at the university. We are very passionate about this, about sports, so they should make their plans very clear to all of us. Otherwise, we are tired and disappointed in whatever is going on down there. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I think it's about the time we listen to the candidates. But first of all, let me just read a few comments on Facebook before I later on switch on Twitter and get those tweets that you sent in through. Olinga Emmanuel Jackpot says, I'm Emmanuel, and my question goes to Honorable Kumakech. How would you feel when you win the election tomorrow? Okay, thank you very much. And we have a lady called Karunji Rachel says, I'm following closely, and I believe in you guys show how unique our university is. That is Karunji Rachel for you. And more comments coming through, but I'm just going to post them there, then get back to you candidates. Starting with you, you heard the questions that have been raised. First of all, Charles made a comment about sports that you're talking about jokingly, and I think they should introduce something called sports union. Do you agree with him?
Yes, I agree with you, my brother, and that's what I'm looking for, to see that actually the University of Kisubi get registered with Inter-University to make sure that we are on board, because I believe these people, once you are their member, there is a way you can benefit from them. So it is in my view and my prayer that I get on the top post, and these things start immediately to see that we also shine among the giants in this country.
So now there is something somebody raised still who called in to you, Komakech, that you know the university is now independent. Did you get that question very well?
Yes.
Elaborate more about what this person talked about, because the university is independent right now since 2015. And I don't know, I didn't get the question very well, but I believe you noted it down.
It is a very good question, and I've been a member of GRC, working so closely and reading every day this article, the constitution. The first constitution that I am going to work upon and through writing to submit to the GRC and the Dean of Students to look through is the Article 13 that talks about the election. We are not so big in number, and they say we should get 51 plus. That makes it very hard, and we go through reruns, cost, and other things. So this is the first thing I'm going to do. Then secondly, we are going to sit down, because it is not one man's work. We have to sit down, the stakeholders, to see which constitution need to be adjusted so that we find ourselves suiting to the university and all of us are enjoying equal right at the University of
Missouri. And lastly, a question for you before we can listen to other candidates. Somebody said that the university has been privatized. And it so happens that a couple of things that the government, that the current government is doing is so close to the administration more than the what? The students themselves. How is your government going to be so close to the students more than the administration, or both? And how are you going to balance that?
Well, coming from the background of social work, we believe that every community should have a solution. Now, you know, the government, we need to engage the students to listen from their views. And that is the bottom-top approach rather than top-bottom approach. That's why you look at my goals, looking at creating a free platform where students and the lecturers come together to agree and find a solution for the issues that are going on. That is one of the strategy I'm going to use. Because if we continue to be different from the students, we are not going to achieve, including the question that my brother asked, what so far have we achieved? So these are the only way we can put the students accountable. We give them the feedback, we engage them, we let them discuss themselves and find a solution for their own problems.
Now, given the fact that we don't have enough time, and I want to finalize with you, Mr. Honorable Komakech. I want you to look in the camera, convince the people watching you why they should elect you as the next Guild president before we switch to our brother.
Thank you very much. I have 100 reasons why the people of University of Kisubi should believe in me, both the weekend students and regular students. One, my motto alone engage every single individual in that community for a better unique. That means I will be the only person responsible for all of us to come together, agree on issues, and find a solution amicably. And two, I have a greater vision which is in line with the University of Kisubi, lobbying for more students, lobbying for more sponsors. And all these things need to be engaged with the students together to see that every success accomplished by group, but not as a single individual. And I know in marketing, the students themselves are the great marketeers. So we have to engage in them, involve them, and make us move around this country and get students on board. And we move on, and we stop crying for one thing so that we move to another success. So I believe, my dear friends, at a different level, whether they're at home or at hostel, please give your vote to Honorable Komakech Francis, the person who can suit your needs and your demand. Thank you so much. Thank you.
All right, the questions are kind of so many that have been raised, but we don't have enough time. But Mr. Vincent, in just 30 seconds, somebody talked about the constitution of the university, given the fact that now it's independent from Uganda Matters and COSI. How can you respond to that briefly in 30 seconds before you give your final remarks?
Okay, thank you very much. I would let you know that most of the African countries were colonized by the British, but we are now following the American culture. The same thing, what we need only as University of Kisubi, now that we are independent from COSI University, we only need to make our services equality for everyone to achieve so that our university can grow bigger even than COSI.
Okay, your final remarks. Tell people why they should vote you. Students of UNIK are now watching and eager to listen to you.
Okay, thank you very much, moderator. My request to the students from University of Kisubi is to kindly vote me for my competence, my flexibility, my capability and ability to adjust to each and every condition, each and every environment, and to vote me for academic transparency and quality service delivery. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Sir, pass the microphone to your next candidate. Just a few comments. I can't read your comments, people, but let me send some shout-outs. JFK Ruta, you're watching the show. Thank you so much for that comment. Master Mwalimu, you're watching the show. Thank you very much. Mwahire Ronald, thank you so much. Lorita Lorita, thank you. So many weird names here, but Lorita, thank you very much for that. Let's listen to Mr. Paul. Tell us something about how you're going to be closer to the students of UNIQ, because they have realized the government that was in power is so close to the administration than the students. In just 30 seconds.
Thank you so much. I have been telling my agent that what we need this time is the president who will work for the student and not the person who will work for the administration. And that is why I am coming on board to work for them through the administration and not working for the administrators.
Okay, your final remarks.
Dear audience listening to me, please, I humbly request your support, your vote, because I hope that I am the most competent person who will create channels through which we can get sponsors and scholarships to students. Because myself here, I'm also here being sponsored by so many people, and I believe they have been promising me that if all goes well, that they will increase the number of sponsors that they will give to University of Chisubi. Not only that, I am the person who will work on sports and connect people internationally so that we can compete with other people, like the connections I have in Kenya where I studied previously. I am very much willing to connect, take people in terms of sports for them to compete to other people internationally and for them to get connected. I am the only person who can create, who can give equitable welfare services to all UNIQ students. I will also make sure that empowerment will be there and as well create channels and avenue for students to acquire and exercise their skills and as well acquire skills that will help them and make them standard and pragmatic people in the future.
All right, let's listen to Ms. Daisy. Tell us about something, just 30 seconds, how you're going to connect your government and the students.
Well, one of my inspirations is to strive not for success, but to be valued. I intend on working for the students, put their needs way before mine. And I intend to stand for what they want, make their dreams come a reality to the university.
All right, final remarks. People are watching, and how can you convince them to vote for you?
Well, I ask for your mandate because I believe I'm the best candidate. I prayed myself on my reputation to follow through and meeting deadlines. When I commit to doing something, I make sure it's done and on time. I look forward to an office that values the ideas that I can join with, a strong team, and have an impact on students' lives. Thank you.
All right, thank you very much. And of course, comments, I can't read them, but I can send some shout outs. David's Richard, I can't read your comment, but shout outs to you. Prosy Precious, thank you for that comment. I can't read it, but thank you very much. Mr. Simon Peter, a couple of questions were raised for you, but now we can't go into details of them. But however, tell us about something you're going to do about the constitution of the university, given the fact now it's independent, in 30 seconds.
Yes. Actually, one of my items that I want to address in this constitution is to see the amendments of some articles. For example, the Article 13 that talks about elections, where we have the rerun when someone does not raise 50% plus one vote. That is what I intend to amend.
All right, final remarks?
To my dear colleagues, brothers and sisters of the University of Chisubi, I want to assure you that the University of Chisubi needs a president who stands for their goals and interests. A president who does consultative leadership at all levels. A president who is confident to air all their views. A wise man called Socrates said, "Politics or leadership is not a pure science. It is rather a venture worthy of a man with wisdom and experience." Based on my experience in leadership, I hope and believe that I can be the best choice to lead the University of Chisubi. Thank you very much.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls watching us from all parts of the country, those are the five candidates running for the Guild Presidency of University of Chisubi. We have Honorable Komakech Francis. Voters of Komakech Francis, let me see your hands. Voters of Komakech Francis. Where are the voters of Honorable Rukundo Vincent? And then let me see the voters of Honorable Paul Oshia Onue. Where are the voters of Komtima Daisy? And finally, we have Honorable Simon Peter. Well, I just want to appreciate all the callers that came through. If you're unable to call through, we apologize for that. We don't have enough time, but always, and we appreciate this Urban Television. All the comments that came through on Facebook and Twitter, thank you very much for that conversation and socializing with us and finding us, giving us all the time and the questions that are coming through. And of course, I would like to remind you or notify you that views expressed on this show they don't even affect any way the Electoral Commission's decision. So it's upon you, students of UNIQ, to go out and step out of your hostels, step out of your halls of residence from your homes and go vote for your favorite candidate. Otherwise, I remain MC Cass Mill. Have a good night. Keep watching Urban TV. We have a movie coming up for you. So keep it locked. Yes, sir.